owl. I brought you a bag full of broken toes and tricks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. The funniest man of the whole human race is gonna put a smile on your face. Just keep laughing, you're a little bit proud. Bozo is back, the one that...
Introducing Bozo, the world's most famous clown.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Howdy, boys and girls. Heidi ho and howdy to you, Mr. Gorilla, and welcome on a beautiful Saturday morning. Oh, I hear ya, to my Bozo Super-Duper Saturday Circus at the Bozo Big Top here at TV 13. Hey, you know what? It's a beautiful Saturday it is, and you know what, I know why? Because a week from today, it's Christmas Eve morning. That's going to be a beautiful time of the year, the season of love. Hey, I'm glad you're here this morning, too. Oh, yeah, because we got our games and our prizes, our cartoonies, and lots of surprises. And also, Mr. Gorilla, we're going to continue our month-long salute to the Cub Scouts and Boy Scouts of West Michigan. And Uncle Bill Steffen's going to be here, the famous meteorologist, to talk about the arrival of winter next week. We got a beautiful, talented baton twirler, and we'll play our Meyer Bozo Bucket Bonanza Grand Prize game. Hey, once again, we'll remind you about Toys for Tots, and of course, your super good pictures, and a whole bunch of birthdays coming up this weekend and next week, so we got a lot of fun things going on. And Mr. Gorilla, I have boys and girls visiting, mostly our scouts, of course, because we're saluting scouts this month of December, from Grand Rapids and Fremont, North Lake Village, and the fine town of Coopersville, where Bozo was about a week or so ago at the big Christmas parade, too. How about a nice wave, guys and gals? And if you want, throw a kiss out there. Well, like that to your husbands and wives. Oh, faster, 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 faster. Oh, look at them throw those kisses, Mr. Gorilla. They really do love those kisses. Hey, you know what? We're sort of wrapping up the year now in a couple of weeks, of course, and Bozo still sees a lot of my friends in many spots. We have two final Christmas parties coming up this weekend to sort of wrap up the year. Let me show you on the Bozo list here. Today, we'll see all my friends in Grand Haven at the special party for the Grand Haven Eagles Christmas party. We'll be out there from 2 to 4 p.m. today. And tomorrow, Bozo sees all of his pals for the last time in this year of 1988, of course. We'll be at our final party we do every year, the big Muskegon Heights Eagles Christmas party from 2 to 4 p.m. So I'll see you today in Grand Haven and tomorrow at Muskegon Heights. Okie doke. Hey, boys and girls, and especially my scouts, can everybody stand up nice and tall? And I know at your scout meetings you do the Pledge of Allegiance, don't you, good buddies? Okay, let's put our fingers to our forehead if you're a scout. Otherwise, put your hand across your heart here if you're not a scout, and we'll give our love, respect, and devotion to our beautiful flag and our great country. And I love the way the scouts do the salute, Mr. Gorilla. They do it very, very well. And boys and girls, I've got our American flag right here, the beautiful Old Glory American flag. All the scouts and boys and girls ready? Okay, let's give our love, respect, and devotion. Moms and dads, would you like to stand and join us? Thank you so much. All together, here we go. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Give yourselves a big hand for our great job there. All right, give me a high five, Ryan. Thank you so much, good buddy. Boy, Ryan, give me another high five, good buddy. Thank you so much. How? Ryan, you're supposed to give me a high five here. Wait, let Jonathan try. Jonathan, you try it. See, that's the way to do it. Let's try it again, Ryan. Good. All right. I don't know how that guy's doing it, Mr. Gorilla. Hey, you want to go see a cartoony? It's coming up on the Super Duper and your telescooper too, good buddy. Oh, yeah.
Let's listen to the news. Gee, Bozo, what kind of news?
Good news, because today's the day the United States is going to test my troubleshooter computer.
Washington, D.C. has just reported the disappearance of the Bozo troubleshooter computer. It is believed to have been taken by Slippery Bly.
This is a job for old Super Sniffer. Here, Sniffer, front and center.
You hollered, Bozo.
I sure did. That spy guy Bly got away with my troubleshooter computer.
Look, it takes two to tango, and Bly only got one computicator.
Well, hey, day in the morning. Maybe this one will help us pick up Bly's trail.
Listen, I'm getting a bleep on my bleeper.
What does the beam mean, Sniffer?
As they say in the movies, he went that away.
Well then, hey, hey, and away!
Now that I have this hot computer, I need a cooling off place for both of us. Oh, how fortunate for me. The city dump. They'll never think of looking in the city dump.
Nobody would ever think of looking for Bly in the city dump. Better see if we're still on the beam, Sniffer.
Oh, my. The computer seems to be a bit sick. The poor thing is confused by all the metal junk in the dump.
Then it's time for you to take over, Sniffer. Here's one of your Super-Duper XYZ3 bones.
Thanks a heap, Bozo. There's nothing to fear. Super Sniffer's here. Stand clear.
Hold it, Sniffer! Are you all right, Sniff Boy?
Oh, yes. I'm fine, Bozo. Just fine. But watch that first step. It's a doozy.
Oh, how humiliating. I've been found by a hound.
Yep, that's him. He took a flyer under that tire. Hold the nose and fire when ready.
Now, Bozo.
Fire away.
Oh, I'm sorry, Bozo. I guess I overdid it.
Well, at least we're in this thing up to our ears.
Won't those two snoopers ever learn?
Look, Sniffer, he just dunked under that junk. Whoa-wee! You got hit by everything but old Slippery Bly.
Sure, everything but the kitchen. Sink?
This whole situation is going from bad to better.
There he goes! Turn on the nose!
I would if I could, but my sniffer's all snuffed out.
Well, then you better take another Super XYZ bone. Catch!
Oh, dear. This ought to be interesting.
Well, I'll be. Look at what that XYZ3 did for me. Yes, sir. That's my baby.
No, sir. I don't mean maybe.
How about that? Like the old adverb says, he who sniffs best... laughs last.
Hey, Mr. Gorilla, I got all the boys and girls right here for our first game. And don't go, ouch, did you pinch me there, Scotty? Cut that out. We got our salute to scouts today, a week before Christmas Eve, some Christmas music, a baton twirler, and Mr. Bill Steffen, I believe, is going to be here to talk about the first day of winter. But we got our first game, and we're going to play around the balloons right there in the potato sacks. Now, Brian, this is your team here, right? And what's the name of your team, you know?
Miss Piggy.
Miss Piggy's, all right. And Scott, what's the name of your team?
Pee-wee.
Oh, you got me right in the eye when you said that. That's a good shot. You got Pee Wee Herman like that. Okay, when I blow the whistle, go around. Root for your favorite team, okay? On your marks. Get set. Not yet. There they go. Go around as quick as you can. Who's going to do it? Who's going to do it? Look at them go. Pee Wee Herman, let these guys go. Okay. Oh, the Miss Piggies are in the lead. The Miss Piggies are in the lead. Come on, guys. Get the next one in there. All right, let's get that. Those guys. Get out. Get out. There you go, Scott. Here they go. Go at the end of the line. End of the line. Okay. Look at these guys go. All right. Who's going to do it now? Who's going to do it? Look at those guys go. Get ready. Bring up Con. Con, come here, good buddy. Okay, hop right in there, Con. There you go. Get out, guys, as quick as you can. Look at that guy. He's dragging him to Cooper's belly. Oh, look out there. Okay, look at these guys go. Look at these guys go. There you go. That's good. That's good there. Okay, look at these guys go. Good job there. Okay, next two players here. Did you guys go already, Kevin? Did you go? Not yet. Okay, that's good. Go around there. That's good. That's good. Okay, go around again. Go around again. Gotta go around again. Go around again. That's good. There you go. Go around again. That's good. Okay, last two players here. Go around again. Go around again. Go around again. That's good. There you go. Last two players here. Okay, come on, guys. Get it. Go around again. Around again. There you go. Around again. There you go. That's it. Can they do it? Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Look at them come back. And it looks like Miss Piggy team won. Boy, Boy, these guys, you guys were taking a long time. How come, good buddy? They were going by way of Coopersville, Mr. Gorilla. Hey, you know what? We're going to make sure all the boys and girls, the winning team and the almost winners, get Bozo goodie bags to take home. But first, let's see a nice person who recently had a birthday many fingers old. Watch this. Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
We will return to Bozo's Super-Duper Saturday Circus right after these messages.
Clint Eastwood is a little upset.
It seems some misguided individuals out there are abusing our public lands. They're vandalizing our public parks and playgrounds, and they're overrunning our wild areas. Real nice guys. Some clowns are even stealing artifacts from historic sites. Now, when I hear about things like that, it really bothers me. I find it unacceptable, and I know you do too. Because these lands are ours, yours and mine. Now, I know what you're thinking. What can I do? Well, you can either sit there and do nothing, or you can start by getting some information on how you can help stop land abuse. As I see it, these people who are abusing our public lands can either clean up their act or get out of town.
Bad guys abuse public land. Good guys save it. If you want to help, write Take Pride in America, Post Office Box 1339, Jessup, Maryland 20794.
If you made a pledge during Requestathon 88 Toys for Tots, send your contribution to Toys for Tots in care of NBD, 200 Ottawa Northwest, Grand Rapids, Michigan 49503. Or drop your pledge by any one of the NBD branches in your area. WZZM and WLAV asked for your help, and you gave it. Over $34,000 was pledged. Because of your generosity and support, thousands of needy kids in West Michigan will wake up to a new toy on Christmas morning.
If your car's engine were to stop, you probably know what to do to get it started again. The sad fact is, more people know how to jumpstart a car than know how to save a life. Learn how to jumpstart a life. Learn Red Cross CPR.
Back to Bozo Super Duper Saturday Circuit.
Thank you. Hey, Mr. Gorilla, I was mentioning about birthdays a little while ago. If you're ever having a birthday, send to Bozo. We'll put on the Super-Duper Telescope. Hey, what did that say? That says birthdays up there. And I just did the birthdays, Mr. Gorilla. I know I did, good buddy. Really, I did. Hey, let me remind all my friends, if you'd like to come see Bozo here at TV 13, just like we have our beautiful scouts here, or, you know, if you're with a church group or a school group or just friends from the neighborhood, well, please write in for tickets, okay? But just a reminder, there are no tickets available until April 1st. Of 1990. That's right, that's a year and a half from now. So if you want to come see Bozo before you're too old, you better write in now, for at least not next year, but the year after. Okie doke. Eddie Spaghetti is going to tell you how you can come to see the big Bozo. Oh, yeah.
Hey kids, how would you and your friends like to come to Bozo's Big Top here at TV 13? It's lots of fun and everybody will have a great time. Here's how, and it's really very easy. Just have Mom or Dad write in for tickets and join us for the games and prizes, cartoons and surprises. Send in your ticket request to Bozo, care of TV 13, Box Z, Grand Rapids, Michigan 49501, and come on down and have some fun.
Start writing now for April of 1990. Hey, here's my pal Eric. How you doing, Eric?
Good.
You're doing good, good buddy. Hey, I'm gonna give you one of these beautiful phantom hats. Look at that. Look through that. What color you see?
Red.
It looks like fuchsia or puce to me, good buddy. But you're right, it's red. And show everybody your Bozo Big Top t-shirt. That's his Bozo Big Top t-shirt from the Earthbound t-shirt shop of Grand Rapids. He's gonna take that home. He looks good, hat. And we got some more prizes for you, okay? They're right here on the Super Duper Hella Scooper, good buddy.
What a great selection of prizes for our friend today. First of all, it's an Orange Crush can holder. Also, a giant Tootsie Roll filled with 100 Tootsie Rolls, a safety booklet, and some bumper stickers. Also, the Incredible Hawk comic book, a Pizza Hut hand puppet, and a golden instructional book, and other nice prizes. Congratulations.
Yeah, this is Eric, and he's my butchie boy. Eric, good job, good buddy. Hey, how long you been in the Scouts now, my friend?
2 years.
2 years, you enjoying it? Oh, yeah, it's a great organization, and we're going to be talking about it in a couple of seconds, but all those prizes are yours. But Eric, come on over here, good buddy. I want you to sit down right over here. Can you do that for Bozo? Right down. Ow, my hand. Did you see what he did, Jennifer? Stepped on my hand, that little guy there, too. Hey, Mr. Gorilla, I got to remind all my friends, I kind of hope, I even know it's a busy time of the year, that you'll draw our color Bozo a picture. How many of you guys can draw a color pretty good? We got some good drawers of colors here. Well, everybody goes home after our circus. I want you to draw our color Bozo a picture. You can draw anything you want, and we'll put it on the Super-Duper Telescooper. Don't forget to write your name in the city. And here are some nice pictures from you guys out there on the Super-Duper. Oh, yeah. I love those pictures, Mr. Gorilla. I really do.
Who's got a beard that's long and white? Santa's got a beard that's long and white. Who comes around on a special night? Santa comes around on a special night. Special night. Beard that's white. Suit of red. Santa wears boots and a suit of red. Who wears a long cap on his head? Santa wears a long cap on his head. Cap on head, suit that's red. Special night, beard that's white. Must be Santa, must be Santa, must be Santa, Santa Claus. Who's got a big red cherry nose? Santa's got a big red cherry nose. Who laughs this way? Ho, ho, ho. Santa laughs this way. Ho, ho, ho. Ho, ho, ho. Cherry nose. Cap on head. Suit that's red. Special night. Beard that's white. Must be Santa. Must be Santa. Must be Santa. Santa Claus. Who very soon will come our way. Santa very soon will come our way. Eight little reindeer pull his sleigh. Santa's little reindeer pull his sleigh. Reindeer sleigh, come our way. Ho, ho, ho. Cherry nose, cap on head. Suit that's red. Special night, beard that's white. Must be Santa. Must be Santa. Must be Santa. Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, and Blitzen, Reindeer sleigh, come our way. Ho, 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 cherry nose, cap on head, suit that's red, special night, beard that's white. Must be Santa, must be Santa, must be Santa, Santa.
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. Oh, yeah, must be Santa Claus time, Mr. Gorilla. And that's coming up a week from tonight. Hey, what do you want for Christmas, good buddy? You got something special this year, Ryan? What would you like, good buddy? Hold that mic open, Sean.
Well, a remote control car.
A remote control car? I'd like to just have a car, much less remote control. Shawnee there, good buddy, what do you want for Christmas this year?
Something remote control.
Oh, you also want remote control. Let's find out what little shortcake. What do you want there, shortcake?
A race car.
A race car? You guys like the remote control stuff right there.
Mr. Gorilla,
you like that too. I know you do. These are three of my friends. This is Ryan and Sean and my pal over here. What is your name?
Robert.
Robert, okay. And these guys are members of our Scouts, and we are saluting the Scouts. And Sean, now you are a Boy Scout. Is that right, good buddy? How long have you been in the Boy Scouts now?
1 year.
1 year. And before that, were you a Cub Scout also?
Yeah.
Right. I see. You look, well, you're not that old, 139, are you? No. That's your den number?
Troop number.
Troop number there. And I notice you got a lot of badges and stuff like that. Congratulations. Are you enjoying that being a scout too, good buddy? Boy, look at that, your kerchief holder there too. What is that?
My dad carved it.
That's an Indian, is it not?
Yeah.
Oh, that's beautiful. He did a good job on that. And you think maybe you'll be going on to be an explorer, something like that, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay, well, we're so proud to have you here as a Boy Scout. And he started off as a Cub Scout, too, Mr. Gorilla. Now, we have one of our Cub Scouts. This is Mr. Ryan. Mr. Ryan, how old are you now, good buddy?
Seven?
You look more like 7:15 to me. That's a joke, Ryan, good buddy. I'm glad you laughed. Hey, Ryan, how long have you been a Cub Scout now?
2 years.
2 years? You having fun being a Cub Scout?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's been the most fun thing you've been doing the past 2 years? You got one thing in your brainy brain, in your memory, that you remember that you had a fun time doing with all the other guys?
Making ornaments.
Making ornaments? That's nice. Was it for the Christmas season or just another time of the year?
Christmas.
Christmas. That is a fun time and enjoyable, too. Hey, let's go over to my pal Roberto over here. And Roberto, good buddy, turn around here. You are what we call what? Is that good, buddy? What
do
you
know? Tiger Cub.
You're a Tiger Cub. You don't know to root for the Tigers or the Cubs, right? I think so there. And this is your first year in the Scouts? Huh?
Yeah.
You enjoying it?
Yeah.
Yeah. How old are you now?
Seven.
And do you think you'll be going on to becoming a Cub Scout or a Boy Scout, maybe?
Yeah.
Well, we're very proud of you. You're having a lot of fun doing the good stuff, right?
Yeah.
Okay, you're a good-looking guy there. That's my pal Robert and Sean and old SpaghettiOs over here, too, old Ryan. And you know what? Your youngster can join the scouting movement, be it like a Tiger Cub or a Cub Scout or a Boy Scout. All you have to do is call the local telephone number, and you see it's right on the screen there, and I got my little number here to remind Bozo what the number is. In fact, you see what that number is there? Let me read it for you, okay? It's 363-3828. That's 363-3828. Maybe you can become a member of the Tiger Cubs or the Cub Scouts or a beautiful Boy Scout, too. It's a great organization for young people, and we're very happy to salute them all month long. Shawnee, let me have that microphone, and why don't you three guys go over there and get a good jumbo Tootsie Roll for yourself. Let's give them a nice hand, guys, for a great job, too. Yeah, the Scouts of today, we love Mr. Gorilla. Hey, I gotta show you something over here, too. This is our Toys for Tots canister, and you know what? There's less than a week to go for the 1988 campaign. Oh, yes, it's been a great year. We put a lot of these canisters all over the Grand Rapids, Kent County, West Michigan area, and a lot of boys and girls, moms and dads and grandmas and grandpas have put toys in there, so some of the needy boys and girls who maybe won't be getting a Christmas gift this year will have a brand new or unused toy. And thanks for helping us out this year. This was the biggest and best Toys for Tots campaign ever. Now, we don't have much more time, you know. Oh, within less than a week, we'll be giving all the toys, but they're still time to help out. And you see, here's another telephone number you may want to jot down and help out old Bozo and the Marine Corps Reserve and our Toys for Tots campaign. 363-1699. That's 363-1699. And help us in the Toys for Tots campaign. Okie doke. Hey, let's see who's having a birthday this weekend. I bet all little Ronnie Stockwell of Grand Rapids is 10 fingers old. Hey, guys, let's sing our birthday song. Y'all set? 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
We will return to Bozo's Super-Duper Saturday Circus right after these messages.
He's waking up.
Hey, Ralph. Pleasant dreams.
What's going on?
You know what day it is, Ralph? He just turned 18.
That's right. Our Ralphie's reached his prime.
Who are you guys?
I'm your conscience, Ralph.
And I'm your fun side, Ralphie boy.
Ralph, the law specifically states you must register with Selective Service at the post office within 30 days of your 18th birthday. Do it today, Ralph.
Ah, come on. What's the rush? Have some fun, dude. Rock and roll.
If you don't, you won't be eligible for federal student loans, job training, or most federal employment.
Big deal.
Oh, it only takes 5 minutes. You can register before you clean your room.
Can you stand that much excitement?
He has to.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'll register.
Good.
Then I'll take in a movie.
Attaboy, Ralphie!
Oh, but Ralph.
Listen to your conscience. Register with Selective Service.
Hang on to your seats.
What's going on here?
It's an art fight.
No, it's DC Follies.
I have no recollection of that.
The show that tackles the issue.
Tennis, anyone?
And puts the scandal sheets to shame.
Not the worst dressed. I'm the least dressed.
With the spotlight on comedy. Join Fred Willard.
What?
And the Crowd Puppets.
I like that.
On DC Follies.
Sunday at 5:30 on TV 13. When it comes to feeding the hungry, a can of food can go a long way. This holiday season, you can help feed the needy in West Michigan by participating in Operation Can Do. Just take a can of food to any Elias Brothers restaurant between now and December 31st. Drop it off in the WZZM Elias Brothers Can Do display, and you'll be doing your part to make someone's holiday season a little brighter. WZZM Elias Brothers and you, together, we can do it.
Now back to Bozo Super-Duper Saturday Circuit.
Hey, there's the gorilla. Don't go away. Got lots more cartoons, a beautiful baton thriller from the Kaiser classic Sailorette, and also meteorologist Bill Steffen to talk about winter coming next week. But first, it's time for the Meyer and Bozo Bucket Bonanza Grand Prize Game. Okay. And my pal, thank you guys again, my pal David is here. Hey, David, let me have that card right there, good buddy. You're going to play the game. He's a scout, and we're going to play for someone up north. Can you read that name? That's okay. I'll do it for you. It's Joey Tucker, who's 2 fingers old, and he lives in what city is that? Chippewa Lake in Michigan. You talk so soft. What's your name? Hi, Laura, you've got little braces like me. Yeah, I know you do, huh? Hey, that means every prize that David wins, we're going to send to Joey Tucker. I believe that's up north in Chippewa Lake. David, you're older than 2, aren't you? Yeah, I think so. So good luck, a chance to win all these prizes, including Big Bird, the Fisher-Price trike, and the wagon that could be yours, too. So good luck. Boys and girls, get ready to root them on. First, we're going for bucket number 1. Everybody get your hands like this. Everybody get your hands like this. All good. Okay, get the first ball down there, David. Okay, bend over, try to put it in the first bucket. He did it! There you go. And you will pick up prize number 1 and give it to the clown right over here. Thank you so much. Hey, it's my official Bozo, the world's most famous clown, doorknob covered. That's right, it glows in the dark. And there, oh, she looks much better. And right like that. And you see, there you go. And of course, this glows in the dark, and that's kind of nice. David, put that right down by your goodie bag, okay? Now we're up to bucket number 2. Hands together, everybody. Hands together. David, get the next ball. Bend over. Try the second bucket. He did it! Your side, I'll hold my side. 100 jumbo Tootsie Rolls from Tootsie Roll, Chicago, Illinois. And it's a reusable bank filled with assorted Tootsie Roll candies. And of course, David, you can put all your pennies, nickels, dimes, and quarters in there. Save up for a big trip to Marne or Ravenna. Okay, good buddy? I know you're going to like that too. But remember, real cereal, I mean serious, anytime we have candies, after that, you always brush and floss your teeth, okay? You don't want to get any cavities or false teeth like some people I know. No, she doesn't have. Hold on to that, good buddy. That's heavy. No, you don't have false teeth, do you? I know that, you cutie. Okay, now what bucket? Wait, don't go yet. We're up to bucket number 3. Get your hands together, guys. Hands together. Okay, good luck. He did it! It's a pizza party, right? Yeah, this is it. From Parker Brothers, the brand new pizza party game. Making, matching, switching, snatching your piece of the pie game. And it's a brand new Christmas toy from Parker Brothers, the pizza party. I see you back there. Okay, David, that's for you, good buddy. Now we're up to the yellow bucket. Number 4. Hands together, everybody. Here he goes. Take a big deep breath, David. Bend over, give it a shot. Oh, David, wait, the game isn't over. Get the ball down there. Now you're going to go and try to play the game for David. Oh, yes, put your shoes right together. There you go. That's good. Now let me show you which one. It's for Hop Along Big Bird, the yellow bucket. Take a big deep breath. Everybody get your hands like that. Let's see if she can do it. Go. She did it! Wow, Mystic, look at that. That's the Hop Along Big Bird from Sesame Street. Everybody has a fun time hopping along with the old Big Bird. Ooh, that's a heavy one. David, put that by your goodie bag way over there. Okay, now we're up to the blue bucket. Get the next ball, Mom. And this is number 5. Hands together, everybody. Hands like this. Good luck, Mom. Take a big deep breath. Okay, good luck, the blue bucket. Oh, no, she didn't do it. But I'll tell you what, love, you did a good try. You missed out on the trike and the wagon, but you got a goodie bag for my friend over here and 4 prizes. How about a nice hand for them, too, guys, for a great job. Good job, Dave. Thank you. And, of course, all the prizes in my Bozo Meyer Bucket Bonanza Grand Prize Game provided by Meyer, the toy store for West Michigan, and, of course, for the Christmas season. And I'll tell you what, your first name again is... Lori, Lori, hallelujah. We're going to send the same prizes to, who's that again, Joey Tucker? What city is living? I'll tell him, Chippewa Lake. You can win prizes too. Yes, you can, like David and little Joey Tucker. As many times as you want, send us your name and address to Bozo's Bucket Bonanza and Meyer, of course, at Television 13, Box Z, Grand Rapids, Michigan. And the zip code is 49501. Lori, come on over here. We got a little game for you to play now because you're going to get a chance to win a nice prize. Would you like that, Lori? Okay, now you see we have our Bozo magical door right there. Now, we're going to give you a chance to get a prize. Do you want door number 1? Okay, let me show you. This is door number 1, okay? Or do you want door number 2? Or you can have door number 3.
Which one would take your time? This is a toughie, I know. Ooh, yes. Which number?
Two.
Two. Oh, are you sure? Okay, let's open the door and see what's behind door number two. Oh, looky, Mr. Gorilla. She gets... Oh, hello in there. Hey, it's a jumbo Tootsie Roll and your own Odyssey Passbook valued up to $30. That's for you. Now, you want to try for door number one or three? Which one? Three. Are you sure? Okay, Laurie, let's see what's door behind door number three. And it's... Oh, it's a Bozo goodie bag. Let's everybody give her an The goodie bag is yours. And our own little cap, which makes you our beautiful queen king for the day. Turn around, face everybody here. Mr. Music Man, here we go! Oh, look ahead. Give her a nice hand for a good job. Let me fix you up, Lori. You're so pretty, my love. Let's go see a cartoon, okay? Keep smiling always. I know it's hard. You're so silly, Lori.
I never done any birdie watching before. You'll have to clue me in on it, cousin.
First, we find a real rare kind of bird.
That's how I like my birds. Real rare. Slurp, slurp.
Then, we just watch them. Get the picture?
Just watch them? You do the watching, I'll do the eating.
Now cut that out, wacko. We're not about to eat any birds.
What are we, vegetarians or something? Huh?
According to this bird book, we're in ring-necked eagle country.
According to my book, my cookbook, that is, young birds roast up real easy.
Wacko, you can't eat eagles. Sounds like an eagle lives on top of that skinny old rock.
You mean that's one of them delicious little old birds up there?
Wait a minute.
Relax, cousin. I'm just gonna check out that little old nest for eagles.
Don't go near that fierce eagle. He's dangerous.
That's strange. I can't hear a word he's a-hollering. Instinct tells me something's up. Or, on the way up. Big man, going around bothering us helpless boys. Big deal. It's getting so an eagle isn't even safe in broad daylight. I tell you, this scaling the heights bit is like work. I promised to protect my kid brother. And that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I thought I'd never get in reach of it. He sure is a hardcore little old feller, isn't he? I didn't know eagles wore star teeth. Yeah! Oh! They always leave fast when you put the bite on them.
Wacko, you mean to stand there with that wolfish grin and tell me you're gonna try again?
I got me a gizmo this time, what's gonna get me to the top.
Yeah, but what if that eagle burst your balloon, buffoon?
This here little old play toy is punk cure proof. I'm sure getting up in the world. All right, already? Catch! Great poppy eyed hoppy toes. Look at what's coming at me. If I miss it, I'm a goner for sure. You know what? I'm sure gonna have an awful headache in the morning. With this guy around, who needs a TV set?
Wait a minute, Wacko. That stuff's dynamite. I wouldn't fool around with it.
That's exactly what it is. Dynamite. And I'm not fooling.
There's a time to stay and a time to go. And I'm gone!
Move over, cousin, because things are sure going to boom, boom real soon. That stuff should have ought to gone off by now. I better, like, look into what's holding up that boom, boom.
Wait, Wacko! Come back!
By jingo, that was a humdinger of an ear ringer.
the illegal legal off and me. What do you know? It took a featherhead to give Wacko the bird.
Hey, this is the Gorilla. We're rocking and rolling 1 week before old Santa Claus comes to town. Oh, yeah.
Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it rose. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Thank you. Oh, yes, Santa's going to be here a week from tonight, Christmas Eve, and Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Has everybody got one special gift they want from Santa Claus this year? Okay, at the count of three, everybody tell Bozo what that one special gift you want, okay? One, two, three. Sure, I knew that, Mr. Gorilla. And I hope you guys get your beautiful gifts, too. Hey, birthdays, we got a lot of them next week. It's a beautiful time to have a birthday during the season of love. Little Andy, where's Becky, is going to be 14 years old. Matt Siegel of Grand Rapids, I remember him when he was a little guy. He's a big 10 now. The lovely Lori C. McCarthy of Kentwood is a quarter of a century. And lovely Andrea Hallis of Grand Rapids' birthday. And also Rosalyn Arbanis of Grand Rapids. TV 13 news director Mr. Ken Colby is nearing 40, and Rosalind's husband Dave is having a birthday. He's going to be 50. Let's sing our birthday song. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Birthday sent at the Bozo, we'll put it on the Super-Duper telescooper, or maybe mom or dad, or brother or sister, or grandpa, grandma, your school teacher, or friends, okie doke. Hey, Butch, you hold on all this stuff for me. We have a beautiful baton twirler coming. You grab a seat right over there, okay? Where's that beautiful baton twirler? Here she comes, the beautiful, beautiful baton twirler. Hi, pretty lady. What's your name? Hi, Tina, and you're a member of the Kaiser Classic Sailorettes, right? Could you perform for all my friends today? Okay, why don't you stand right over here. Mr. Music Man from the beautiful Kaiser Classic Sailorettes, here is the beautiful Miss Tina.
I met a wonderful lady in my dreams last night, and I learned the reason why Santa Claus never missed a flight. Oh, I dreamt that I met Mrs. Santa Claus, and I won't forget Mrs. Santa Claus. She's the busiest person I know, because when Christmas time draws near, she counts all the cookies and candy canes, chooses the toys and electric trains, wraps them in ribbons and cellophane for our Christmas cheer. When Santa's almost ready, she helps. Bozo checks his list for the names he's missed and sends him on his way. Though I always will love Mr. Santa Claus, 'cause he makes Christmas bright. Thanks to Mrs. Santa Claus, Christmas turns out right.
Christmas didn't always turn.
Hey, Tina! Come here, hon. Good job. There you go. Take a bow. Take a bow. That's good. Thank you, guys, dear, too. Hey, Tina, come back here, hon. Where you going? You come running back and forth here, too. Turn around. How long have you been performing now? Baton twirling. A year. You're very, very good. I get a little butter on my finger sometimes. I drop my spoon, you know, like that. But you did very, very well. Have you been to parades and activities and stuff like that? Good. And maybe you'll, maybe some do it for the Detroit Lions. They used to be a football team, remember? Yeah, many years ago. Hey, I tell you what, if you want to learn how to become a member of the beautiful Kaiser Classic Sailorettes, just like my pal Tina, and do the beautiful baton twirling, give them a call. There are two telephone numbers on the screen right now where you can call for more information for the beautiful Kaiser Classic Sailorettes, and you can learn to do baton twirling. If you go over there and see that funny-faced little girl. See that funny-faced little girl there? She'll give you a jumbo Tootsie Roll, okay? There you go, hon. Good job. And a goodie bag, too. Hey, boys and girls, how many of you guys are scouts? Raise your hand again. Okay. Do you know I got somebody here that was a scout a couple of years ago, and he still is very active, our own meteorologist. Let's give him a groovy hand. Bill Steffen! Yeah! Hey, Mr. Bill,
hey,
it's true. You were a Cub Scout and Boy Scout, too,
sure
right?
I sure was. I was a Cub Scout and Boy Scout many, many years ago.
Are you still involved with the Scouts?
I'm still involved with the Scouting. I'm still on the board, and I have been involved in Scouting now for, I believe, let's see, lots and lots of years.
Lots and lots of years.
Almost 27
years. Well, what do you think are our good-looking
years,
Scouts here? We got the Tiger Cubs. We got
Ooh.
Cub Scouts. We have a couple of good-looking Boy Scouts
mm-hmm.
there, too. And these guys are Scouts, too, and we're so proud to have them and have you here. Hey, let me ask these guys. What's going to be coming up on December 21st, a new season? If you know it, yell it out. Winter, right.
Oh, yeah. And
winter
see,
is coming.
It feels like winter already outside.
Oh, it's been cold.
Boy, it's been
cold.
Chilly.
You
it's going to stay kind of chilly around here. It's going to be a cold winter, colder than last year.
It's going to be cold. I'm going to wear my long jeans.
It's going to be enough to turn your nose red there, I think.
Well, it's happened already.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
But you know, when, as soon as we get next week then, on the December 21st, don't the days start getting longer, Mr.
The
Bill?
The days start getting longer after next Wednesday. In fact, the sunset time is already getting a little bit later. It's getting so dark, you know, early before dinner time.
Oh,
now
yeah.
It's going to start to get a little bit later when the sun goes down.
And winter's a cold time of the year.
Winter's a cold time of the year. You can see on the picture there, winter is coming right there on your TV. And the next one there shows a picture of my old friend Frosty the Snowman. You know
Frosty
him.
The Snow Person. Yeah, you got to call
all
him Snow Person
bundled
now.
Up for winter. You know,
yes.
It was so cold around here the early part of last week that he had goosebumps. A
Frosty
snowman
had
with goosebumps.
Goosebumps. I
can
didn't
you imagine
see
that?
That?
It was that cold around here.
Oh, but it's pretty, though.
Yeah, and we see the sun coming up. Sun sets in the southeast. And again, the sun is way low in the horizon. And that's why it's cold around here with the short days and everything else. A lot of things to remind the boys and girls about. One is to bundle up in the wintertime. Wear lots of layers of clothes and make sure you wear your gloves and your hat and boots when it's cold out and snowy.
I always wear my gloves.
Yes, indeed. Take a look at the next one. You'll see somebody you recognize.
Hey!
Who's that funny guy with the big red nose?
It's not Dan Quayle.
Bozo. I see Bozo's next to him, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Well, we're getting all set for the snow there. You got your
you
sled
betcha.
There. A lot of fun things you can do in the wintertime. You can go sledding and skiing and skating right here. I want to remind the boys and girls that the ice is still very thin in lots of places, so be very, very careful before you venture out on the area lakes here and make sure that ice
good
is very
idea.
Thick.
And also, Bob, I was going to say, though, even though we're here officially winter, it's going to be colder in January and February,
January's
probably.
January's our coldest month, and it really doesn't start warming up much until about the second or third week of March.
But it's a fun time of the
and
year.
And winter officially comes in at 10:28 next Wednesday morning.
Oh, right, the boys and girls will be in school,
right,
I bet.
Right when that funny man Dick Richards is on the radio.
I know
on
him.
WCUZ.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So 10:28,
next
when does
Wednesday
winter
morning.
Officially arrive? 10:28 in the morning. What time? 10/28,
Wednesday
morning. These guys got it.
Mr. Bill,
always
so
good
much.
To see you, my friend. I love that blue, that jacket
season.
Here, too.
Like that Michigan State green.
I can just something
Jesus.
Here, too. Hey, you
green.
Know what? We got to go by the Bozo Bulletin Board. Come on over here, Mr. Bill, you and I.
Let's do
and
that.
Look at all the beautiful pictures we got over here. Look at this one from Maureen. And she's, I'll put this way back over here so the boys can see.
Okay, it's Walker, Michigan.
Well, I know where Walker is, sure.
Pretty close to we are.
And
we
Maureen is 9. Mm-hmm. And over here, look at that. We got Michael and Francis in Holland.
And they put their pictures on there.
And they're age 5 and 6. And this is Kyle, who's 4 fingers old. And what's that name up there?
Oh, what a neat picture. Nikki, it looks
like. Six
fingers
old. And this is from Katie
Boy,
that's
a nice
Muskegon.
Picture.
That's beautiful.
That looks like summertime to me.
I think so. And this one says from Jill in Walker, just keep
laughing. Like you and me.
And from Joel, who's 4. And finally, from little Mikey, 5 fingers old. We love your pictures. Keep sending the Bozo and Bill. We'll put it on the Super Duper and the Telescooper, too. Hey, it's cartoony time, okay?
Hey, I'm excited about that.
I love that green jacket. I wouldn't wear it myself, but I...
Here we see the research center used by famed professor P.D. Woofer.
No, no, not P.D. Woofer. The name is Tweety Woofer. I mean Tweety Woofer.
Tweety Woofer?
Sure.
Oh, sorry, professor.
Well, that's all right. It takes a P.D. Woofer to say Pooty Woofer.
Howdy, professor. What super secret invention you cooking up today?
Well, Bozo, this is my latest and greatest invention.
Looks like some kind of a box or chest.
Yes, it's mine hope chest.
And I just hope it works. What's that button on it for, Professor?
Oh, that's the starter stopper open the topper button.
Anyway, I think it is.
Well, Jiminy all padlocks. Let's find out. Super costume peppers. Whoa-wee, that's not a hope chest. It's more like a hop chest. Cowboy! Get me out of here! I'll stop that crazy carton from starting any more trouble! Poor Nelly! Why did you stop stopping it? Because it stopped me first! Look, my hopper chest is getting away!
Somehow I've got to get a look at the professor's new invention. My name isn't Slippery Bly, international spy. You know, I think I just did.
Come back here, you hippity-hoppity pest chest.
I have to beat that clown to the box. Now I got it surrounded in this blind alley. First things first, and the first thing to do is to confuse that clown. Oh, this is going to be so easy.
Well, hoot nanny, look who's got the box. It's old Slippery Bly. Okay, Bly, hand over the professor's invention.
This one isn't his invention. Honest Injun.
That's your story. I'll just take the box back where it belongs.
I told you it would be easy. And now I can spy on the professor's secret invention all I want.
I got your invention back okay, Professor.
Wonderful, just wonderful.
Nothing to it, Prof. Just put it down over there.
What? My hop chest didn't have the booming and the banging in it. What gives?
I almost blew sky high thanks to that Sly Bly guy.
Could be that Spy Bly fella's too much tricky for us.
Yeah, but I got a hunch he's not trickier than that clicky tricky hop chest.
Now to find out what this secret invention does, I'll just push this button. Ooh, how interesting. Something tells me I shouldn't have started this thing. Huh? I don't like the way that ghastly invention is looking at me. Wonder what this nut's trying to tell me.
Scram!
I am! It got me!
Gosh, old Nats Knuckles, look what's coming. I wonder why the weird knick-knack came back.
I just wish I knew what that thing does.
It goes around catching innocent spies. That's what this thing does. Ooh, stop it.
We will return to Bozo's Super-Duper Saturday Circus right after these messages.
Dear senior friend,
you can make a senior citizen very happy.
I hope you have been good this year.
Just send a homemade Christmas card to Senior Care Cards.
Because if you've been good, you'll get lots of toys.
WZZM's weatherman will show your cards on Eyewitness News 13, then deliver them to a senior friend.
But if you were bad, you get nothing. At least that's what Mom says.
WZZM Senior Care Cards.
And have a Merry Christmas. Love, Matt.
Who are the great American investors? In Alaska, they're people like Big Dave Wunsch, Bush pilot. People like jewelry carver Amos Wallace. Coast Guardsman Maury McFadden. And Bill Winters, Park Ranger. People like you and me, we're the great American investors. Over 30 million Americans invest in U.S. savings bonds. Because bonds pay competitive rates like money market accounts. And they're free from state and local income tax. Plus, you can start your investment plan for as little as $25. U.S. Savings Bonds, the great American investment. Find out more. Call 1-800-US-BONDS.
Back to Bozo Super Duper Saturday Circus.
Hey there. But get back, everybody. Get back there. Hey, Mr. Gorilla, just a reminder, I'll see all my friends at the big Grand Haven Eagles Christmas party this afternoon, don't you know, from 2 to 4. And tomorrow, I'll see all my friends at the Muskegon Heights Eagles Club and their big Christmas party tomorrow from 2 to 4. Okay. Hey, we got time for the break in the balloons on the big X game with your boomy booms, right? Oh, you cutie pie. Okay. And let's see, your team over here. Now, what's the name of your team? You are?
Over the Hill.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, no, that's the name of your team. I'm sorry. Over the Hill's here. And you are?
Auntie.
Well, you could have fooled me. Yes, sir, sir. And you've seen many yesterdays. I know that. Okay. So root for your favorite team. Over the Hill, Antiques, or Yesterdays, okay? Now, remember what you got to do. Help your youngsters down there with the balloons. Okay, everybody behind the lines, guys. On your mark. Get set. Not yet. You were ready to go, weren't you? There they go. Go down there. Stick it again. Put the balloon on the X. On the X. Put the tire around your tummy. Tire around your tummy. Okay, now break up and down. Break that balloon. There you go. Good. Okay. Now, next player. Next player. No, your turn. Your turn. Your turn, good buddy. Wait for your partner. Wait for your partner. Wait for your partner. Okay. Turn around. Face the camera. Have him face the camera. He's not facing the camera. There you go. That's it. Who's going to do it? Look at that guy go. Look at these guys go. Break that balloon. Okay. There they go. Okay. That's good. Okay. There they go. All right. Come on back now. As soon as you get back. Okay. Leave the tire. Leave the tire. Will you leave the tire? Don't take my tire, silly. Okay. That's good. Sit right on the X. Okay. Can't they do it in time? Can't they do it in time? Look at these guys. Oh, my goodness, don't hurt yourself. Well, wait a minute. These guys, some of you guys didn't go, so we're going to give you a little bit more time. Who didn't get a chance to break a balloon yet? Okay, you guys help your little, big people help when I blow the whistle. Not yet. Not yet. Got to get back here, Mom. Get it back here. Okay, all set now? Okay, now, you got one more team here, right? How many teams over here? One, and how many teams over here? You got, how many you got, one or two? You got two, you got one or two? One, okay, now you stand over there, then here. You stand with your youngster over there. A little bit more, sweetheart, a little bit more, that's good. Okay, you guys all sit. Now, did you get a balloon too, good buddy?
Yes.
Well, get another balloon, because we're gonna have two, two, two. We'll see which one of these three. Okay, do you have another balloon from there? Okay, on your marks. Get set, get ready, get ready. There they go. Go down there. Come on, guys. Get on the X. Get on the X. There you go. Who's going to do it? Is it going to be Over the Hill or Antiques or Yesterday's? Okay. Who's going to do it? Okay. Come on back. They've got to break. Both of them. They got to both break them, guys. Both break them. Okay. Come on back. There they go. There she goes. Come on now. There you go. Okay. Can they do it in time? Did you guys do it already? You got another one here? This is the winning team right over here. Another nice hand. And you guys were the almost winners. And wait, how's Steven doing, Mom, huh? How's he doing? Okay, is he trying it now? Is he doing pretty good? Okay, why don't you come around here? And tell you what, come on around here, Mom. And Steven, yeah, you hold the balloon like this. Oh, pardon me. Now, Steven, turn around, face in here. Pull the tire up. Pull the tire up, Steven. Okay, now you put the tire on the X, Mom. See the X down there? Okay, don't hurt Steven, sweetheart. Okay, all right, now we're going to give him the countdown, okay? Let's give him the countdown. 10, 9. 8, 7, 6. He did it! All right, there, two. Okay, now all the boys and girls, all you boys and girls, go over and get your goodie bags, okay? And bring that bag of balloon to Bozo here, okay? Very good job. And moms and dads, let's make a straight line, just like the Rockettes. Just like the Rockettes. Look at this, the Rockettes. Get those legs up there, girls. Exercise time. There you go. Here's a balloon for you for doing a good job. Don't go away. One balloon for you, funny face. And we have a balloon over here for Miss Coopersville. Okay, and there you go. And another one here, and another one here. Stretch your balloons out, moms and dads. Stretch your balloons out, okay? All right, guys. Take it. Don't be that strong. Take it out. There you go. Okay, guys. Let's see who's going to blow the biggest balloon. Mom's all set? Okay. Start blowing when I blow the whistle. On your mark. Get set. Not yet. Not yet. You went too fast, didn't you? You silly. Oh, you got me right in the eye. She got me right in the eye. Hey, let's remind everybody, peace, love, kindness, love your mom and dad. We'll see you a week from today, Christmas Eve, a special time, 11 o'clock in the morning, just for next Saturday morning. Okie doke. Till then, just keep laughing, good buddy. All set? On your mark, get set. Get ready! There they go. Blow them up, girls. Blow up those balloons. Blow them up. Blow them up. Come on now. Look at these guys go. Look at them go.
Does the universe
kind of needs help, improvises, throws it away again, and we are set for our 8th punt of the night. Thus far, the 49ers should think about going back to the drawing board, because what they are calling is just not working against this defense. The play before this, they had a flood to the right, and I'm sure George Seifert is thinking just the same thing. They had a flood to the right. There wasn't one receiver open that time. Downfield wasn't open, and they just had to throw it away.
And you saw the Giants saying to Hamer, hey, when are you going to call grounding here?
Look at the coverage. And there's no, it wasn't Montana, but this time he's in trouble. As a man crosses over the middle, he has to throw it away.
Well, Mike Wilson was the closest 49er receiver. He was a good 10 yards away.
Here's Helton's kick, very inartistic. And it plops us down at the 43-yard line.
Natural surface
blocked by Mike Fox.
A natural surface will not give you much of a roll either.
No.
We've seen some very poor punting tonight. We've seen a lot of poor stuff so far tonight. Mm-hmm. Under Blandetta said, look at that, Bill. He can't kick either.
The nesting instinct is a desire to settle down.
Say what?
Couples become placid.
In a Grand Am sedan? Get out of here. This thing's so quick, you'd never know it's a four-door.
They gladly repress their own desires.
Dream on. Being sensible isn't boring in a Grand Am.
Dream
Some people see shaving as something you do for 3 minutes a day. At Braun, we see it as something you do for a lifetime. And we think you should make the best of it. The Braun Shaver, with its three shaving positions. Designed for those who choose to make a virtue out of necessity. Braun, the world's number one selling foil shaver.
The Mona Lisa has no eyebrows. Venus de Milo lacks arms. Chickens have no lips. Why ask why? Try Bud Dry. It's cold filtered for smooth draft taste and dry brewed for no aftertaste. So when it comes to refreshment, nothing's missing.
The Raiders are driving for a division crown, but to stay in gear, they'll have to stop Detroit's wheels. Next week on ABC's Monday Night Football.
Beautiful Coit Tower on Telegraph Hill in San Francisco, built to honor San Francisco's firefighters. A spectacular sight. We'll take an elevator ride to the top, great tourist attraction. And back we come to Candlestick. Giants from the 43, Anderson to the outside, and Ronnie Lott finally runs him out of bounds after a gain of five up to the 48. First half so far, been a punting duel. Four for Helton, four for Landetta. And there it is, every Giant possession resulting in a punt.
You just joined us, you haven't missed a whole lot.
Yep. Well, we mentioned at the top, it had the makings early on of that, you know, the classic heavyweight fight, a little feeling out process, but the crowd is ready for a few haymakers here.
I can assure you there is intensity down there. There is major league hitting.
Second and six. Sims, it's caught by Bavaro. It's a first down, and Lott rides him down at the 29-yard line. And there is your first haymaker, 23-yard pickup.
And I wonder if Ronnie Lott is thinking back to 1986 when Mark Bavaro gave him about a 10-yard ride. But this time, Bavaro comes across the middle. They chuck him at the line of scrimmage, try to cover him with Haley. That's not good at all. Haley's a great football player, but he cannot cover a Bavaro. And Bavaro, who still perhaps is only about 90-95% with a bad knee, gets the first down inside the 30.
Just to follow up, he was ejected last week. He was fined $500, which is the normal fine. The case, though, is still being reviewed by the league. He could be suspended. It's possible. The case is not closed. To the 29-yard line, no gain for Hampton. The reason, of course, is that there was contact with one of the officials in Philadelphia last week, and the league is still looking at it. And here was that play in 86 to which Frank referred.
You didn't see this. You're not going to believe it.
Watch Ronnie Lott.
Coming back from 17 points down, and this was what set off an eruption that ultimately brought the Giants the victory. That's almost impossible.
Mm-hmm.
And with Ronnie Lott, who took the major ride in 86, and I think he was maybe thinking about it a few moments ago.
And the Giants rode that play right to the Super Bowl. Second and 10. Fake to Hampton. Sims with room to roam. But coming up to make the tackle is Bill Romanowski at the 27-yard line.
Oh, great job by Darrell Pollard. Deep downfield. Sims was trying to get the ball upfield to Ingram, and Pollard just would not let him get by.